is fury from North Richmond residents after the Andrews government introduced legislation to make the medically supervised injecting room permanent. But after saving 63 lives and managing 6,000 overdoses, Daniel Andrews is yet to confirm if the CBD will also host a site, despite buying a building for that purpose.
5 years after the trial began, the Melbourne supervised injecting room will become permanent, leaving nearby school parents reeling.
Well, we are not happy because the kid is too young.
They're addicts that are not good shape, wandering around sometimes. Mostly, you know, most days it's not a problem, but there are cases where it is a problem.
The fact is that the only people who are winning out of this situation are the drug dealers, unfortunately.
The Premier says the service will be overhauled.
There'll be some changes to the way it operates, more wraparound services, greater involvement of nurses.
The decision comes after a review by John Ryan found that the trial helped manage 6,000 overdoses and save 63 lives in the facility. However, there were still fatal overdoses in the city of Yarra during that period, 50 deaths between July 2018 and December 2021, compared to 68 over a similar period before the injecting room was established.
To have safely administered some 6,000 overdoses without any loss of life is quite remarkable. We also know through the recommendations that there's more work to do.
The centre has recorded hundreds of thousands of visits, but while the injecting room's goal was to save lives, another goal was to improve the amenity for local residents. A goal it seems the Premier believes is not the priority.
This has not been just about the amenity of this area. It's been about saving lives.
The report doesn't investigate whether the site shouldn't be next to a primary school, with the Education Minister unable to elaborate in question time.
Does the Minister stand by her statement that no one has died within the proximity of the injecting room?
I stand by my comments yesterday around how well the school has been operating and excelling in its NAP plan results and its engagement of kids.
The decision also raises the question about a second site, likely in the CBD. For the first time, the Premier confirmed the government's bought a building for that amid high speculation that the site is next door to Melbourne's iconic coffee laneway, De Grave Street.
We've bought a building. We think there's a strong case to have a second injecting facility. However, it's got to be at the right location.
You've just said then, and I think this is the first time that government's acknowledged it, that the government has bought a building in the CBD for the purpose of a second...
We buy lots of buildings. We buy lots of buildings.
If the government have already purchased a site, why won't they release Lay's report that Andrews needs to come clean with the community and say, why did he buy a building?
The government is due to receive former Chief Commissioner Ken Lay's report on the second facility in the middle of this year. Simon Love, Sky News, Melbourne.